Hi everyone, how are you doing? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today is a brand new Friday, brand new video, and as you know, today I'm wearing a watch. It's a gift. Is it even working? It is working. So welcome back to my YouTube channel, and my name is Doreen Muramura. If you're new here, please click the subscribe button. Let's grow together. Like, share my videos, and the more you share, the more you watch, the more we become a beautiful, huge family in I Am a Beautiful Story. I have said so many things. Anyway, today I want to talk about something that has actually been happening in our country a lot, and most times we do not address it. A few weeks back, this girl came out and said she was releasing a list of men who she had infected with HIV. And she's not the only person. Over the years, I've seen so many people come out and say, hey, I have infected 3,000 men, I've infected 500 men. And most of the time, it's women who actually do this. I've never really seen a list of men who have said that I've infected this number of women. If there is a list, please let me know, but I have never really seen it. But I've seen a list, so many women come up with lists. Sometimes they're there, sometimes they're fake, sometimes they exist, sometimes they do not exist. So most of these stories get picked up real quick by internet users, and they spread like wildfire, and everybody is excited. I don't know whether you're excited to know who has been infected, because we have a lot of people living with HIV publicly who have come out to speak about their status, or you just like, we're just low-key sadists. I have never really understood that, but for some reason, these are the kind of things that excite a lot of internet users for reasons that I've really never understood. But why I'm actually doing this video is because a Facebook user asked me, when am I releasing the list of men that I have also infected with HIV. Of course, I blocked him and deleted that comment, but then it prompted me to say, because I've said all over and over again that I have never infected anyone with HIV. Why? Because first of all, I'm not a sadist. Second of all, it's just a mean thing to do to infect people with HIV knowingly. And thirdly, it is against the law to actually infect people knowingly with HIV. The only reason why most people do not get prosecuted is because there is the burden of proof on them or on the person who was infected to actually say they infected me knowingly. But most times you find that people come out with all of these bizarre accusations and say, I've infected so and so, I infected a million people, and people get excited. And now when this person asked me this, and I said, I've said before, and I'll say it again, I have never infected anybody with HIV. Why? One, because I've always been open with my HIV status. Secondly, because there is protection to be used. So I don't compromise, I condomize. Three, because I am undetectable. As a person who is undetectable, I have reached a point where I cannot infect anybody with HIV sexually. Thirdly, because there is a whole science behind HIV infection. What do I mean when I say a whole science? I mean, there are people in the world, it's 0.1%, I think, who cannot be infected with HIV. Most of them are found in a country called Ireland, or is it Ireland? Whichever, the spelling, whichever, but you know which country I'm talking about. And they cannot actually get HIV because of their immune system. Thirdly, because also when I say the science behind HIV infection, I mean it's harder for women to infect men with HIV. It's science. That is science that is proven. Also, there is the issue of circumcised men. Men who are circumcised are not have a 60% chance of not getting a HIV infection. That is why at some point there are parts of the country where voluntary male circumcision programs were being held by UNAIDS, by other NGOs, so that they can encourage these communities to get circumcised in order to reduce the number of HIV infection among men. So when I speak about HIV, it does, when these people say I have slept with 100 men and I have infected all of them, That is a lie. I can tell you that without fear, and I can, you can take this to the bank. You cannot infect 100 people. Why? Because there's some of them you will sleep with who will ideally not get infected. There are some of them who the immune system, maybe you are, the strain of HIV that you have might not affect them. There are some of them who, by good luck, they might not get infected. So the all these people coming up with this list, 90% of the time, are lying. All I have gotten messages from people telling me, oh, Doreen, you know, I have actually infected, like I have met this person, they're infecting people knowingly, they're saying I was also infected knowingly, so I'm also going to infect people. But it does not work like that. HIV infections do not work like that. You all have to stop this excitement out of ignorance. We are living in 2021. The reason why some of us have never infected a single soul with HIV is because we actually understand how the HIV process works. Just because you had a HIV exposure, just because you had sex with somebody who is living with HIV, does not mean that that equals to an infection. Can we normalize that? Can we be better? Can we do better? Can we at least try and get information? Because not every sexual experience with a person living with HIV equals to a HIV transmission. Okay, I am not saying that you cannot infect people with HIV. You can, if you are not on treatment, if you are not detectable, if you have numerous and multiple opportunistic infections, and if you're basically your immune system has gone down and you have like multiple sexual partners. It's something that can happen. But it doesn't mean that every person you sleep with, then it is equal to a HIV infection. If it was like that, the numbers that we have will surpass the 1.5 million people living with HIV that we have. Because as a country, we are careless and reckless when it comes to HIV. So one thing I'd like to tell you guys is, people will never be able to disclose their HIV status to you willingly. So can we please, please normalize using condoms? Can we normalize testing ourselves? Before you come to me and tell me, Doreen, how can I sue this person? Did you at least before the start of the relationship, did you at least try to test each other? Did you at least try to know the status of this person, the HIV status of this person? Because most of the time, we just start dating and sleeping with each other and asking each other if we trust each other. The only trust you're supposed to trust is trust condoms, okay? So please, normalize testing, normalize using protection, because HIV is real and people are not ready to disclose their HIV status. So up until this moment, I want to say thank you so much. Continue watching my videos, and see you next Friday. Bye-bye.